an addict. Before I go on, I will be talking basically about substance addiction, but some of the points that make you a substance addict also can relate to your addiction. Now, there are when we think of addiction, we only think of drugs or alcohol, but there are all types of addiction. There is gambling, there is sex, and all its twisted forms, pedophilia, and there is, you know, in porn as well. There is addicted to your computer, addicted to TV, addicted to making videos. Woo! I'm very addictive. I've got a lot of addictions. Addictive to buying things, addictive to food, addictive to the way you look, even addictive to work. And all these addictions, as I have explained before, is because we are missing something. Now, a lot of theorists believe that a lot of it is because of abuse, neglect, or some other childhood trauma. Now, that doesn't explain other people who are addicts. So you could say peer pressure could be one. An adolescent may go to a party and be offered a joint or offered a can of beer and like it. Next minute, they're addicted. There's also genetics, like I explained with my father. I think I was cursed all over. I got it from my father. I've had trauma, and I've also got mental health issues. I've got anxiety. I've got post-traumatic stress disorder. There's a question mark over ADHD, and I've got borderline personality disorder. Borderline personality disorder itself has risk-taking, self-harm, and addiction, and sex, and also, and that just fits me perfectly. And addiction is self-harming. Now, you may think that if you're addicted to work and you're working long, long hours, that that is not harming, but you are, because life has to be balanced. But anyway, I'm back to the video. Are you a substance addict? You are a substance addict, or what's known as substance user disorder, if the substance you take is you're taking larger and larger amounts, and remember that's due to tolerance, or over longer period than intended. So if you just do something once, you're not an addict. If you do it once and come back 10 years later and do it again, once, twice, you're not an addict. This is where you take larger amounts to feel the same thing, or you continue it over a period of time. So I may take binge drink 2 days this week and binge drink next week. I'm an addict. The second thing that makes you a substance addict is a persistent desire or unsuccessful attempts to cut down or control substance use. So I can clearly say, because I have cut it out, I am no longer an addict. And that is why I disagree with NA, because at NA you introduce yourself and say, I am an addict. No, I'm not. I once was an addict. But remember, an addict is persistent desire or unsuccessful attempts to cut down or control substance use. Now, for the last year before I stopped, I had a desire, but I didn't quit. And I knew, I saw my husband die, but I didn't quit. Number three, if you know you're a substance use addict, if a great deal of time is spent in activities necessary to obtain the substance, use the substance, or recover from its effects. That's withdrawals. So, you know, that's taking time to go to, say you're an alcoholic, taking time to go to the bottle shop, getting pouring down your drinks, drinking, so you get to the intoxicated state, and then you withdraw and you feel bad, and so you drink again to take away those feelings. That's an addict. The same with if you go to your drug dealer and you're spending hours and hours trying to get on, and you druggies will know what I mean by saying hours and hours to get on, sometimes days and weeks, but you persist and you're ringing up every 20 minutes, where's my drugs, and you'll spend all your time to try and get your hit. So that third point in the game is a great deal of time spent in activities necessary to obtain the substance, use the substance, or recover from its effects. That also goes for taking the time to get money. A lot of addicts don't have money because, let's face it, drug addiction's very expensive. Drug addiction is ridiculously expensive. And you have to, people do all sorts of things from rorting and, you know, selling themselves on streets to get that hit. And sometimes with opioid users, they have to do this because they feel sick. So let's take, again, the stigma away from drug users. Drug users are not, when they're using drugs, they're not in their right mind, okay? They're not diseased, but they're not in their right mind. You also know you're a substance addict if you crave or you have a strong desire or urge to use the substance. I would also say if something triggers you to use, you are an addict. So a trigger could be a stressor. I have done a video on the central nervous system about the fight, flight, freeze, make friends or pretend to be dead, because all drugs affect the central nervous system and all drugs imitate the neurotransmitters, and that's where we get our rewards and pleasure from. Anyway, number four, you know you're a substance addict if you recurrently use, resulting in failure to fulfill major work, school, or home obligations. I would go on to say, and social obligations, because you may be paranoid. A lot of people, there seems to be two types of substance addicts here. There seems to be the party people or the isolation. So if you're isolating because you're off your face, that's failing to fulfill, you know, your obligation for whatever purpose. So you know you're an addict. The last one, you know you're a substance addict if you continue to use despite knowledge of a persistent or recurrent physical or psychological problem likely to have been caused or exacerbated by the substance. In other words, my husband suffered when he used meth. He had bad come downs. Not only that, he was allergic to ephedrine, yet he would continue to use ice and speed. That's an addict. So another thing, you've got liver cirrhosis, or you've damaged your kidneys, or whatever, and you still continue to drink. Or you've caused damage to your veins, so you go from your vein to your neck to wherever. So you're damaging your body, yet you're an addict. So I hoped I've helped establish what an addict is, but that was a substance addict. The other types of addiction, you know you're an addict if you are, for example, spending lots and lots of time engaged in that activity over other activities, and that activity is eliciting that pleasure reward that I talked about, that pleasure reward thing in your brain, and that you're preoccupied with it, and that this thing makes you feel better in times of stress or in times of pain or whatever it may be. So addiction is whatever you're addicted to that's giving you a pleasure response. But remember, addiction is a temporary thing. When you you get into a stage, and I've got a little diagram here, and I thank the Central Queensland University for this. You have what you call your preoccupied, you anticipate, you use, then you binge, you get intoxicated, and then withdrawal, negative effect. I've got a little, I'll put it over here, and hopefully you can see that diagram. Thank you again to the Central Queensland University. It shows the cycle of addiction. And the cycle of addiction is preoccupation, anticipation. So you're getting ready to use, to the binge, intoxication, and then the come down. Now the preoccupation part, where anticipation involves the prefrontal cortex, the binge and intoxication involves the basal ganglia, and the withdrawal negative effect, the extended amygdala. I always say that wrong, I'm sorry. And thank you again. So please, the other thing you know you're an addict to is this tolerance, where you need to increase to achieve the same desired effect, to get the same reward. I hope I've made sense. And again, I tell people I am not an expert. This has all been researched and spoken from life experience. I have a book out about what happened to Rob. And if you view my very early videos in 2020, you can see addiction. You can see a person fully addicted. I was off my face on meth. Hallelujah, I'm clean. And I'm not doing that to a special higher power. I did it. It's all about self-empowerment. All about self-empowerment and addressing why. So it doesn't matter what you are addicted to, there is a reason for it. There is a reason, whether it be a mental health issue, whether it be trauma, whether it be peer pressure, social, cultural, or, as I said, trauma, or just because you like it, there's still a reason. And again, I would love everybody to just stop and be clean, you know? And as I said in the videos, only you, the addict, can get clean. Only you can do it, but you've got to want to do it. And if you can't do it, then let's do, like my other video said, harm reduction. Love to you all. This is my last video I'm making for the weekend, because tomorrow I have SMART meeting online, and I highly recommend SMART, SMART. Bye. Smart is available worldwide. I'm sure of it. Love you guys.